bit about Entelechy. Since last 16 years, we have helped 1,000 plus businesses and people to adopt smart technologies, which made their spaces sustainable, energy efficient, and livable, and in turn save lots of money. Our vision is to enlighten and facilitate adoption of modern technologies in building systems installations to fulfill growing demand for livable and sustainable building spaces. We are in business of distribution, like we're distributors for Casambi, design integration, consulting integrators, training, and certifications. So let us start with what does smart lighting do? To simply put, any wireless smart lighting systems are a simple, powerful, and flexible way to control lights with easy installation and fast commissioning. Smart lighting should be intelligent and connected, making it easier than ever to create spaces that are more atmospheric, welcoming, productive, and efficient. I know there are so many systems available in the market now. So we just try to, we'll also try to compare one of two technologies in this session. So let us understand the luminaire revolution, which is okay. So I'll just start again from 2010 when the LED, by 2010, LED was established in the market, and the whole electrical scenario became electronics. So there were so many companies who started, non-electrical companies, companies who were not into the field of lighting, they started coming into in this field. And because it became electronics, the possibility of like COB, chip on board kind of sources started coming in. Now, since it became electronics, the possibility of integrating software and intelligence became, so the whole possibility of putting software and intelligence on the chip, on the microprocessor, opened up something which is now we call SoC, which is like system on chip. So there are so many companies, so many technologies who are coming out with different SoCs, with different technology stacks, with different kind of systems. But all this is possible because of the whole change from electricals to electronics. And this is where the possibility of smart lighting and connected lighting started coming in. So now you have luminaires, which has a small chip, which has a software and intelligence inside, and it does most of the things which usually around 4 or 5 components do it in a control system. So let's look at Bluetooth history. You know, as a technology, it was formed in 1998. So Bluetooth special interest was formed with 5 companies who were part of it. Companies like Ericsson, Nokia, Intel, Toshiba, and IBM were the part of it. Looking down, one of very important year was 2006 when Nokia introduced low power wireless technology called Vibri. Some of us know, some of you might not even know about it, but it was the first low-power wireless technology introduced in the world. And in 2010, it was merged with Bluetooth core specifications and BLE as a standard was released. So Bluetooth version 4.0 in 2010 is being called as Bluetooth Low Energy. Okay, let us try to compare some of the wireless technologies which are there in the market. We're not trying to see which is better or which is, this is just to understand what Casambi is and how it works. So if you look at non-BLE wireless controls like Zigbee or Wi-Fi, where the user controls or maybe the controls always has to pass through a hub or a gateway before it could control a luminaire or a load. So here what happens is, if you, I mean, there are other systems where you would find the router is already built in the gateway. So there are different form factors which are available from different manufacturers. But essentially, principally, it remains same that there will always be a controller which has all the logic information, control information, commissioning information, and there will always be a router to route the signals around. So there's always a central point of control in this kind of technology. If you look at Wi-Fi based solutions, again, same, you would always have a router as a Wi-Fi router, and you would always have, again, have a gateway, and you'll always have to go through gateway and router to control your lights and luminaires and loads. Again, here, you have seen so many systems from different manufacturers and different form factors where they've incorporated Wi-Fi on the chip. Again, SoC, which is available, where you have the whole routing capabilities inside the chip itself, creates its own network. But essentially, network is required. And so Wi-Fi network is needed everywhere where your lights or loads are. Gateway and router needed. It might not be a separate, but it's still needed principally. It becomes two single point of failure. So your network is down or a gateway is down. If your network is down, of course, nothing will work. But if your gateway is down, your loads will go into the last state. Control requires for both Wi-Fi and ZigBee coverage everywhere. So no islands allowed. So creating different networks on one installation is also a challenge. So BLE mesh. Now BLE mesh, here you can see there are no hubs, there is no gateway. Your user connects directly to the load. So it doesn't have to write, it doesn't rely on gateway or any router to route the signals. So there's no Wi-Fi network needed, no gateways and routers needed. There's no single point of failure. Control works where you are, even if there are islands in the network. So even if there are many networks in one installation, it still works wherever you are. So network doesn't need to follow you. So this is one of very, very important factor on BLE. Coupled with that, if you look at ZigBee or if you look at Wi-Fi, the power consumption on BLE is very, very low. So that is another aspect which manufacturer or a user has to look into. So Casambi as a company was founded in 2011 in Espoo, Helsinki. So the founders, Timo and Elena, were part of Nokia research team. And when Microsoft took over Nokia, they almost closed down the Espoo facility, and so Timo and Elena, they founded this company after coming out of Nokia. So they knew Bluetooth low energy very well because they were part of the team who created Vibri. Of course, when they founded this company, their focus was to create all wireless controls and on Bluetooth, and to become a solution provider to other OEMs who could develop products, smart lighting products and connected products for the lighting control industry. At present, Casambi is already a market leader for all wireless lighting control in Europe. And if you put all together, ZigBee, Wi-Fi, Casambi has almost overtaken everybody in less than probably 8 years or 7 years. The strategic focus for Casambi was, when they founded, and is will always be to create a responsive lighting control. Look at technologies like ZigBee or Wi-Fi or similar kind of other mesh technologies. Since it uses less channels, secondly, it uses a lot of power. And because of that, if the network increases, there's a big load on the network, and the responsiveness of the control becomes a bit less. But since BLE is a very, very low power and it uses different channels, the system is very, very responsive. And Casambi is very, very responsive for users. The second focus was, while creating the system, was the system has to be easy and fast commissioning. Like I said earlier, smart lighting, most of the systems, it takes hours and days for installers and system integrators to commission the system. So Casambi always wanted to make something which is the system needed very, very less time to commission and very easy to commission. Very important part as a focus was always that Casambi needed to be interoperable, in the sense, if you look at any open standard or a de facto standard, the system who have succeeded worldwide over these years are the systems who have interoperability and communication with other systems really easy. So Casambi wanted to create something interoperable. It is an interoperable system, and they are still focusing on that. And another, like any other wireless systems, the most important thing which everybody looks into as a customer is the system has to be very reliable, it has to be robust, and it had to be a very, very secure. So if somebody asks me, I mean, there's so many people we meet and all customers who ask us, Casambi is a, what is Casambi? And we say it is a wireless system and it just works. So let us look at the technology behind Casambi. So the foundation of the technology of Casambi is it's a Bluetooth low energy. So they introduced BLE and BLE mesh even before Bluetooth SIG had launched the core standards. So they already had a system in place even before SIG had launched the standard. So they know, because they knew Vibri, so they know mesh better than anybody else. So Casambi as a system is very tight in integration, in the sense there are very, very few components which are required in the systems. And you would be surprised by end of the seminar when you see the product overviews. There are only 4 or 5 products in the whole system. That's it. And it does full system solution. So it's a complete lighting control package. And also other subsystems are available now from third party manufacturers in the ecosystem. Let us look at some of the technological key facts. One, it uses protected 2.4 gigahertz channel, which is arguably a jammer-proof channel. So Casambi uses the channels. The communication distance between device to device, is 30 meters. Indoor range is 30 meters. So from one node to another node, or so in the mesh, it can communicate up to 30 meter, and which is line of sight, of course. And in the outdoor, it is up to 50 meters. Can create up to 250 nodes per network with the new firmware which was launched a few months back. So again, probably it is one of the highest nodes you could get on a wireless system without gateway or without any hub. So 250 nodes per network, and you can create unlimited networks in Casambi. So there is no limitation. Theoretically, if you look at it, we could have around 50,000 nodes in one installation. So we can create a very, very large network or large installations or large projects using Casambi. Each Casambi unit works as amplifier and repeater. So each and every device which works as a node in the mesh also works as amplifier and repeater. So the signals are not dropped. No servers, no software license, no IT structure needed. Just you buy Casambi products and that's it. Very important topic, which was discussed yesterday also in some other webinars. And there's so many people who ask whenever there is a wireless systems is discussed. And very important topic is cybersecurity, which everybody is worried about these days. So one thing, let me tell you, Casambi implements one of the toughest or enterprise level cryptography in their products. And so it is as secure as any network can be as of now. So if you look at security here, it has AES 128 encryption. Plus it has ECDH and ECDSA, which is elliptical curve cryptography, which is used by technologies like Bitcoin. So you could understand how secure the Casambi is if you look at that standards. Besides that, the communication between cloud and the mobile phone, which is of course not part of the Casambi system, because there are many different ways of connecting to cloud, but the communication there also, it is on HTTPS, which is also a very, very secure way. So Casambi overall is a very, very secure system. So like somebody said yesterday, anything which can be hacked will always be hacked. And of course, I mean, something which is not being hacked right now, there could be a possible, people are always there to find some loophole somewhere. But Casambi being a standard-based solution, because standards always evolve, so Casambi will always evolve in front of new threats as well. So restore and auto backup of the failure unit. So now, in case if there is any failure in any of the nodes or any of the units, the whole restore and auto backup is available on the cloud itself, on the network itself. So there is no need of keeping a backup of your program or your commissioning or your configurations. So it is cloud supported, so no need for local backup. So even if there is any failure, or even if you want, maybe forgot the password, basically. So everything is available on the cloud. You just have to request Casambi or Casambi representative like us. In case if you face problem, you could get your program back again. So you don't, there's no need for keeping any backup. So this is for the manufacturers, also OEMs who develop different products for Casambi, where different APIs has been released now, which is very, very recent. And so many different applications which are available for manufacturers to create, kind of data harvesting or predictive maintenance or AI, or there's so many other things we can talk about. And of course, like somebody is asking me on the chat, yes, interface with other systems like AV, KNX, and BACnet is also possible, which we'll see, of course, in later slides. Sorry. So Casambi is distributed intelligence and services. So it's a distributed intelligent technology where devices are smart on their own. So each and every device is configured and parameterized on its own, because there's no controller, there's no gateway. And even cloud is not required. So cloud is only required when you are configuring the device for the first time, adding in the network. or you're updating the firmware. Otherwise, you don't require any cloud. So everything, all the logics is inside the nodes and units itself. Intelligence is replicated in every node, like I said, because each and every node are smart on their own, and they know exactly what they're supposed to do in the network. But on the other side, each and every node also has a backup of the whole network with them. So that means the intelligence of that node is such that every single node knows what is going on in the network at any given time. So they're also very, very intelligent. Very important point, next one is, it's a self-healing network and it's a self-organizing network. So if you look at nodes, there's so many nodes. I know there's so many people who would be working on different wireless mesh technologies here. So in case if there is a failure or there's some power down in some of the units or some of the segment of the network, in Casambi, all the nodes will automatically create, organize themselves and create a different path. And it will automatically self-heal. So whenever that failure unit or the power system is up again in that segment, it will reorganize itself again. So network will never be down. So only device which has a problem will not work. Everything else in the network will still work. Centrally also, from cloud also, or locally also. So there is a continuous synchronization happening between all the nodes. So they know exactly what is going on in the network. And whenever a failure unit comes back, if there is a failure or if you're trying to add something, a new device or an old device in the network, especially when you're adding an old device in the network back again, it catches up from others when it returns online, because it will also get the whole backup of the program or the whole backup of the network back again. So beacons. Now, I was going through one of the surveys by Bluetooth, which had a 2020 market survey, which said location-based services would be, so there will be like billions and billions of devices which will be sold by 2024 only for location-based services. So beacon is, of course, was introduced by Apple. Which will be used for location-based services like NFCs as well. So location-based services are going to be an important driving factor for the next decade. This is what I believe. Now, beacons are nothing but a small broadcaster device, which can be used for various different applications like proximity marketing or indoor marketing, because through beacons you could always try to find somebody or locate somebody in the vicinity. Now, all Casambi modules or all Casambi units has iBeacons inbuilt, so there is no extra money, there is no nothing. It is it's all about activating it or deactivating it. But one thing we need to understand is beacon requires a separate app, because it cannot work on the Casambi app. So whenever you activate a beacon device, it will send a message to somebody. For example, you take a supermarket, or maybe in this picture, you look at the art gallery, where as soon as you go towards a picture or a painting, the Casambi device would send a notification and would send something on your mobile which will explain what that painting is. And that can be done through beacons. But it will always be a separate app. But it is there available in Casambi. So in case if any users want it, it can be activated. So now, smart lighting controls, what we discussed, so what we're talking about is lighting controls now, is there's no hub, there's no gateway, there's no network, there's nothing required. It is directly connection of your load or a luminaire with a user interface. So let us look at the architecture or what would be a Casambi installation look like. Now, if you look at on the top, you will see there are so many luminaires. So there are luminaire manufacturers available in the market who manufacture Casambi enamel luminaires. So in an installation, there could be Casambi enabled luminaires like from companies like Alco or Vizini or Zumtobel. There's so many available, which would be communicating with each other. So, and all the dimming functions and functionality and everything again is inside the luminaire. So it is nowhere outside, it's inside the luminaire. Then you could have so many sensors. So like you could have light sensors, you could have motion sensors, implementing daylight harvesting or solar shielding or anti-glare, or HCL is human-centered lighting, which everybody is talking about these days, which could be implemented. So you would have Casambi enabled sensors which are available. And you have different user interfaces. So you have smartphones, which is both Android and iOS. Then you would have Apple smartwatch also works. Android smartwatch doesn't work, but Apple smartwatch works. And you can use any different kind of tablets. There are certain gateways available to talk to cloud or to talk to other systems also. And of course, those are mobile user interface. Then you would have wall mount user interface switches. If somebody wants TikTok also, which is available. So you would have different manufacturers manufacturing push buttons. Casambi makes their own keypad as well. So there are many push button switches available in the market. Now, all of this from different manufacturers will work with each other on the same network and the same installation. So this is how the whole architecture can be combined. This is probably one of that interoperability factor, which probably is one of the biggest success for Casambi. So what we understood the architecture, now let's see what it can do. So what are the abilities of the system? So you can do groupings, you can do different scenes. When you talk about groups, there are unlimited groups you can create. So there is no limitation in groups. So you can create different groups. You can group it room wise, you can group it zone wise, you can group it load wise. It depends how you want to do. So there is whole flexibility available. You can create scenes, there are unlimited scenes again you can create. And there are four different scenes which are available. You could do time-based scenes, you could do presence-based scenes, you can do animation scenes. You could also do global scenes in that, again, which is unlimited. So you can, there's a flexibility there. You could do, you can control RGB, so light color. So Casambi can do up to 8 colors if you, your lamps are not available as such, but RGBW is there. Then you could have color temperature where, but it talks about tunable lighting or tunable white for human-centric lighting, so it can do color temperature as well. It has a gallery option where it becomes a very, very intuitive graphic interface on the mobile where you could take picture of a room and then link your luminaires with any push button or any controls or a dimming controls, and user can actually press that lamp whichever they want to control and they can control. So you can create galleries again room wise, zone wise, whatever way you want. You can in fact even put in AutoCAD plans there if you want, and again those are unlimited. So there's no limitation how many pictures you can put in that. Of course, like I said, you have different light sensors. You can have the manufacturers now who manufacture all kind of sensors for Casambi. So you would have a normal PIR sensors or a long range corridor sensors or a warehouse sensors or high bay sensors or high ceiling sensors, outdoor sensors, waterproof sensors. So all kind of sensors are available. With photocells, with lux, everything is available. Oh. And of course, motion sensors are available. One very, very important thing, which you generally wouldn't see in any other control system, is animation. Now, animation is mostly done where you have a sequence of light operating in a different manner in a different time and fading with each other, or a different kind of scheduling with each other. So generally it's being used, you use DMX to do it, but in Casambi, of course it cannot do everything what DMX can do, but most of the applications indoor you would be able to do without DMX. If you're using RGB, or even if you're not using RGB, you can create different effects by creating different animations. And that is a very important feature. Again, is unlimited animation scenes you can create. Casambi has a calendar and timer inbuilt, so you can create timers, and there is a calendar, perpetual calendar, so you can create for day wise, week wise, or month wise, or year wise. And again, you can create unlimited timers, so there's no limitation of the timers. Casambi has astronomical clock inbuilt, so you could create dawn based lighting, dusk based lighting, sunset based, sunrise based lighting. You can actually give a location of your installation directly on the cloud, and the astronomical clock will start working. You could have remote access. Yes, you can control everything from outside. So probably if you want to control your home from your office, you could always do that. Scalability factor, you could use it from one small device till, like I said, you can go up to 50,000 devices. So, and it's everything is synchronized in the. So now all these features is available even if you buy only one single load. So this is the beauty of Casambi, because you know generally these features are in a hub or a gateway in other technologies. So probably if you look at SoCs, so Casambi is of course an SoC. Till date, if you look at smart lighting, has not been able to deliver on its promises. It's probably because if you're trying to create a smart lighting application using traditional technologies, you require different functions. Like, you know, you will have a wireless networking, you have to create a wireless networking function, then you'll have a dimmer controllers, then you would have RGB sequencers, and you would have a relay controllers, and you will have a push buttons. And putting all of them in place requires a lot of skills, a lot of knowledge as well when it comes to LEDs. And you could still do it, definitely, but then it's expensive, time consuming, and it still not be very efficient. If you, Casambi has brought all these functions onto one single chip, and it's very, very easy to do it. I know you're taking away the whole wireless networking, you're taking away the whole control side of it, you're taking away everything. Everything is on the chip. Advantages, like I said, again, I'll just quickly go through it. Of course, it's a very robust system. It's really managed, Casambi is distributed, smart, connected, it's future-proof. So this is very important. Again, Casambi has over-the-air firmware updates. So you could sit anywhere and you can update firmwares for your clients or your consumers or anywhere. And continuous profiles and updates are available from Casambi and released by Casambi for different applications or any security threat or anything which is there. So it's very, very important. It's very easy to deploy. It's fast to commission. I can give you in comparison, probably it would take at least 60 to 70% less time to configure and commission in Casambi system than any other system. It's affordable. It's a complete system. So it controls each and every source, light source. It can control any light source, which we'll see. And there are already more than a million devices installed worldwide. Benefits per specifier, of course, all they need to do is ensure that chosen luminaires are Casambi ready, and that's it. They don't have to worry about planning, wiring, installation drawings, and all those things. Everything is Casambi luminaires, and that's it. Everything is there. So they don't even have to worry about it. For designers, of course, Casambi is standard-based solutions. So, you know, they away from traditional limitations and the barriers of the systems what we have right now. For consumers, like I said, it's very, very intuitive. And secondly, they could set up their own lighting scenes and they can manage and maintain luminaires the way they want. And it's very, very easy. They can do a lot of things on their own. So they will not bother as an installer. You don't have to go again and again to the consumers. And for manufacturers, the whole interoperability factor plays a very big role, because as a manufacturer, you don't have to develop the whole system. You can just make one part of the system, maybe one controller or one dimmer, one switch, and it's in the ecosystem. It will work with other manufactured products and you can go global. Use case can be used anywhere, but I mean, most of the applications which are demanding this kind of SOCs are daylight harvesting. Human-centric lighting is probably the biggest driver, I would say. Dynamic lighting, smart light integration in BMS, cloud, IoT, central control. So, I mean, it can be used anywhere. So let us go through the products briefly. So like I said, there are very, very few products in Casambi systems. So one is, of course, you have a CBU ASD, which is one of the very old Casambi device and very popular still by OEMs and other installers as well. So the ASD is a device, it's a control unit for drivers with 0 to 10 volt or 1 to 10 volt or DALI dealing interface. The control output, it can be configured as analog or DALI. It takes up to 4 DALI addresses. So it can address up to 4 DALI short addresses like 0, 1, 2, 3. And it has, for that 4 addresses, it has got DALI power it built. So you, again, you don't need a separate DALI power supply. Like I said, analog output is 0 to 10 volt, either sync or source current. It has a digital output, so it works as a standalone DALI, or it's compatible with DALI 2 now also. It does tunable lighting. Can use ZT6, ZT8, or any standards which is available in the market. It will work with any of the standards for tunable light. Easily implementable RGB. So since it takes 4 addresses, so you can use RGBW and you can control RGBW color lamps as well. And controllable switch main output. So it has a small relay port outside to drive external relay. So in case if you're using a driver which is 1 to 10 volt, which cannot be dimmed down to 0, you can always use that port to switch off the lamps. Or if you want, you can use a zero power DALI network where you don't want anything to work on DALI. So even DALI driver shouldn't consume any power, you can use those lamps. Or in home automation, you can use it for any other application like switching on AC or any kind of those applications. Then another product is CBU TED. TED stands for trailing edge dimmer. So it's a trailing edge phase cut dimmer. Again, guys, just look at the dimensions down. I've written specifically for you to see that how small these devices are. Very, very good for retrofit applications, of course. And it has an output of 150 watts for 230 volts and without derating. So even if you have 250 watts of LEDs, there's no derating. You can control full 150 VA. On this with a maximum, of course, output current of 0.65 amperes. So it's a very small device, very good device. It has smart switching applications, so you can convert your normal local push buttons in the house, conventional switches, push buttons into a smart switch by just putting this device behind that switch. It's a very, very good device and very cheap as well. Another device which is also becoming very popular is PWM dimmer. So it's a PWM dimmer for constant voltage LED loads, like LED strips or even profile lights. It has both input 12 volt and 24 volt DC. And it It has a four channel output, so you can again here you can use it for RGBW. Can be used for tunable white applications, in the sense you can use two different circuits of tunable lights because it has four outputs in this. It's freely dividable, and maximum output power for this is 144 watts at 24 volt DC, 72 watts at 12 volt DC. So if you're not using all the four channels, you can use one channel for 100 for maximum power. So this is a very, very good device. This doesn't, it's not only a control unit. If you use this, you don't require a dimmable driver. So it does control and driving also. So you just connect your LED strips directly on the connectors and it starts working. That's it. You still need a power supply. Then this is a very recent device, also a very popular device now. It's called A2D. It has a two channel output. So in this, you can either use as analog output, or you can use as a DALI output. Or here you can use, because it's a DALI 2 compliant, so you can use a DALI 2 sensors directly connecting on one of the outputs. So if you look at outputs, channel one output, you could have output voltage either 0 to 10 volt, 1 to 10 volt. Or you can have DALI output in that. In channel two, you could have again 0 to 10 volt driving. And if you're using as a DALI on one channel, the second channel can be used for connecting DALI sensors there, or you could use it as a relay control as well. Source current, sync current is very high again, so it's also a very good device. And again, it has DALI power inbuilt, so it can also do short addresses. It can also do DALI broadcasting. Yes. And you have CBU DACS. This is one of the devices which yesterday, in fact, there was a new update on this device. This device till yesterday was used for broadcast controls, or maybe used for track lighting controls, or where you need to control all lights together. Of course, it supports 64 DALI short addresses, so it can be used as a broadcast, and it sits as a DALI device on DALI network. So it doesn't require any power supply. It draws power from the DALI network itself. And so till yesterday, it used to work like that. Yesterday, there are new profiles which has been launched for DCS. So now it has become a DALI gateway. So in the sense, now it can be interfaced with any other existing DALI system from any other technology. It doesn't matter anything. But it is optimized for systems like BACnet and KNX. And it can sit there, and it will become a gateway between other systems and Casambi. So this is the power of over-the-air updates from Casambi. In a sense, the same device which was working only as a broadcast, now it works like a full-fledged DALI gateway. We'll see the features about what features changed within one day, just by one firmware update. So this is what Casambi is all about. Okay, Casambi also makes a switch. They make only one switch, of course. It's a four button switch, so you can do luminaire control, group control, control all luminaire, you can recall scenes, recall animations, spot dimming. There are four different buttons which are special buttons. So if you have plus and minuses, of course you select any button and then you can dim up and down with any function. And up and down is for changing color temperature. So you can actually change the color temperature by up and down arrows, which you can see on the switch. So besides Casambi own products, there are so many Casambi enabled products which I cannot cover everything here, because you can get all the information on my website or Casambi website. But one or two products, like most of the architects or customer ask me that I don't like those switches, so I want to buy something else, right? So now Casambi Anocean is available, which is powerless switches, of course, energy harvesting wireless switches. There's no battery required. And I've listed some of the manufacturers here who manufacture Casambi-enabled Anocean switches. So you have Barker, you have Kira, you have Yaga Direct, you have Yong, you can Martin, Vimar, Vimar is already selling in India now. So now you have options of buying all wiring accessories along with Casambi enabled switch in the same range from different manufacturers. Very good for hotels. So a lot of people, hotels demand this for us. So very good for hotels as well. This for somebody who wants to look at the interface side of it, where you could see three, I mean, there is one company called PLH from Italy who make very high-end switches. But they have a product which is called Aria Jellyfish, which is, you could see the same device can be used for interfacing with KNX bus, so using KNX IO. It gets interface. The second one is with Crestron, so it can directly connect with Crestron bus and then the Crestron IO, and you can connect with the Casambi. And you have Lutron as well, so you can in fact configure even Lutron or interface Lutron with Casambi as well. This is something which is also available. So there's a huge possibility now. So let us just look at all the DALI functionality, because DALI is something which is talked about and it's a future, of course. So Casambi supports this following DALI functionality, or is almost all the DALI functionalities, device discovery and address assignment. You can actually address it also. Groups and scenes, creating groups and scenes on DALI. DT6 is supported, DT8 is supported, tunable white, color, RGB, and even XY axis controls are supported. DALI status queries is supported. DALI 2 sensor switch support. D4i, which is also a very recent standard from DALI, which is in-luminaire DALI controls, is also supported by Casambi now. So Casambi ready and DALI devices all can be mixed and matched in Casambi wireless networks together. And Casambi functionality and DALI controller functionality can be mixed and matched together. So one thing I want to clarify here is when we say luminaire in Casambi, so like in other systems, like if, for example, in KNX, you have sensors and actuators. In Casambi, we have luminaires and switches. So luminaires is any device which is used to control loads, or it could be load itself with a control system, controller inside. And switch is something, of course, which gives inputs. So if you have a luminaire with a Casambi SoC chip inside, you don't need external Casambi products. It will do everything inside the luminaire itself. So you don't need to buy any of those A2D or PWM or TED or any other product. You would have so many manufacturers manufacturing luminaires which are Casambi enabled. So you don't need to buy anything else from Casambi. You can just buy the luminaires and start operating through an app. You have all driver manufacturers, all top driver manufacturers in the world. They manufacture Casambi enabled drivers. Osram is already selling in India. Trilonic is already selling in India. So you'll have Trilonic, Osram, TCI, BAG, Helwar is already starting selling in India now. So all those drivers, if you have, you don't need external Casambi controllers. You can directly operate, you get discovered on your app and you can configure directly and then operate directly. These are a list of some manufacturers which I'm showing you here, but there are more than this. There are more than 400 manufacturers now. You can get it on the website. Usage, of course, you have outdoor retail, you can use it anywhere basically. Now, somebody did ask me on the chat, it can be used for outdoor applications. We've already used for, I mean, I would not say it is good for streetlight applications because it's a mesh network. So you cannot have something, a network which is very linear. But yes, if you're using for landscapes or swimming pools or gardens or farmhouses, yes, it can be used because there are already projects which have been done. And there are companies who are manufacturing IP68, IP67 housing for Casambi units. Although the range might reduce using that, but you could always use this for outdoor applications. So I would say anywhere there is a light source, you could control it, and it could be anywhere. It doesn't even matter. So it's almost end of my session. And of course, you could get more information on my website. You can get more information on the Casambi website also. And any detailed questions or any more information, you can always mail me also.